I'm gonna do a annoying thing right now. I'm gonna move my head from side to side. There's a reason I'm doing this. You might have already guessed. Hey, so today we're gonna do some tracking using Kdenlive. Now, I've done some tracking videos in Blender, and if you would like to see those videos, I'll link them below. But Kdenlive has some pretty cool tools hidden in there also. So today we're going to do head tracking completely in Kdenlive and see how it comes out. Okay, so let's start, of course, by grabbing our clip and dropping it in. And I'm going to go ahead and proxy the clip so I can make sure I have all my resources available because the tracking is kind of resource intensive. Pro tip, if you grab the mic, speaker here or the film strip, that's what you're going to bring into the timeline. And we don't need the audio for this. So I'm just going to grab from there and just bring in the clip. Let me make that full width. And all right, cool. So the tracking tool is a little bit different than other systems tracking tools. But the fact that it works right inside of Kdenlive and it works really good means it does a good job of tracking. So step one, we're going to type motion tracker. We're going to grab this and bring it down to your clip. And you always want to make sure you're at the beginning of the clip because you want to track the entire thing. It's going to go from forward to back to track. And it's going to start on the first frame. So you see this red box over here. So that's kind of, I mean, you can leave the red box there and have a red box that follows the subject. But the idea is this is supposed to be so that you can see what it's tracking and then you can make your adjustments. It has other layers too, like as a blur type. So you can have like a blurred face or whatever. But for this one, we're just going to be using the tracking data to track my actual face. Let's get this box over the area we want to track. Here you have your width, your X, Y coordinates, and your width and height coordinates. And you can either punch these in manually or you can just drag and just kind of bring it up like this. So my goal is to track my face as best to the ability. Now, there we go. That seems like a good space, right? Now there's different algorithms that use the tracking, and I really haven't gone into these very much. I'm sure they all have different pros and cons, but I usually leave the default KCF, and that does a pretty good job. Keyframe spacing is basically how many frames in the video you want to track. And by the default, it's every fifth frame. Obviously, the tracking is going to be a little bit out of sync, a little choppy looking, if you would. But it's usually going to be something that someone may not notice, especially if you're doing face blurring. So if you want it to be smoother, you know, go to a lower number, like one keyframe. That means every single frame is going to be tracked. But for this particular little bit, we're going to stick with five because what we're doing is just not really that important. All right. So first thing you do is you have down here, you have analyze to apply effect. Now this is where it's a little bit resource intensive. This process is not multi-threaded. So even if you're like me and you have 20 threads, it's going to still be kind of slow. But that's one of the reasons why you might do every fifth frame. And also, you can also cut the clip down so you're tracking less. But I have a fairly beefy computer, so I'm just going to let it do its thing. And once it gets to the end, we can ch make sure that the tracking works as expected. So it's done. It tracked every five frames. And as you can see, not the most accurate track. But for this kind of thing, it's pretty good. I realize in the preview on Wayland, you may not be seeing the full frames. So I'm going to kind of bring it slow. Yeah. There's a small bug in my system where Wayland captures at not full speed. I don't know what that is. That's an issue for another day, another video. All right, so now we know the track is pretty good. So let's go remove these pixels down to zero. So we can't really see it now. So how do we apply this track to anything else? You see your timeline here, and you click on this little bad boy right here, and you can copy all the keyframes to clipboard. click on that. And we're just going to minimize that and hide it. We don't really need it. Now we're going to go to the transform tool. We drop that in there. If you're new to the transform tool, it basically lets you manipulate your frame. And one of those things you can do is you can have your motion pasted here. So we come here and we go import frames from clipboard. Now, out of the box, there's several things happening. I can see how this could be very overwhelming, but just know that this preview is fairly real time. You can choose your endpoint, your outpoint, your time offset, and you have your mapping. So if you want to track the face, that's going to be offset position. I believe if you want to match something to the video, that would be position or geometry. I forget which. I've only used the offset position, but I know that one works great. As you can see, when you switch to that with those new frames, it looks centered because it's the frame we started out with. And if you want to, you can manipulate the offset position, destination range, yada, yada, yada. There's this limit keyframe number to 20 frames. I'm not sure why that's a thing, but I go ahead and deselect it because otherwise it'll just do the first 20 frames of tracking and then and stop, which would not be cool. So let's hit OK. And now the keyframes are here, and let's test to make sure it is captured properly. And sure enough, the frames have come over. You can really see it there. And it's focusing on my head. So you're probably thinking, okay, this is cool, but I don't want the black to sneak into the frame. And the good news is there's a very easy way to keep that from happening. So the effects stack. So this is the first effect. This is the second effect. And we come up here and grab transform again and add a third step. And this lets us manipulate the output of the second step. So the easiest way to get rid of the black spaces is to punch in a bit. And right now we're at 100% zoom. So we're gonna kick it up to 130% zoom. As you can see in real time, it zooms in. And if we go through the timeline, you'll see that, yep, sure enough, it's keeping us mostly in the picture. We're still getting a little bit of a black bar on the side. I think for my personal projects, I wouldn't worry about that too much, but let's see if we can get rid of that. Let's go 160. That's still there. Damn it, we're just gonna go straight to 200. Now that's a little extreme, but as you can see, it's not cropping off. Now, I shot this in 1080p for a 1080p timeline, so at 200%, it's gonna be quite a bit softer than the original video. In fact, you can probably even see the softness in my preview here. But again, sometimes you have an effect for accuracy, and sometimes you have an effect because it's fun. Oh, there's still a little black in there, isn't there? That's right. I'm not worried about it. At this point, it might be easier just to reshoot the video. So if you ever see me tracking my head in a video, I'm probably using this technique. I'm going to do a annoying thing right now. I'm going to move my head from side to side. There's a reason I'm doing this. You might have already guessed. So this is a fun little tool to use. It can definitely add some dynamics to your video production. And again, you shoot in a higher resolution. Like my phone actually can shoot in 8K, I think, up to 8K. And then I can punch in quite a bit at that point without losing any resolution. Having said that, even when you punch in, it does a pretty good job. You don't see jagged lines as much as you think you would. But it is not nearly quite as crisp if you, you know, zoom in on the same resolution that your final project is. So keep that in mind as you build with it. And it's going to be a fun tool to make more projects, something brain broke. So you found this tutorial helpful? Feel free to give this video a like. And if you like my videos, feel free to give me a subscribe. You can also donate down below through my LibrePay and Patreon. And I'll keep making videos.